It's me, Eleni ASMR. Today I am going to be doing my makeup for you guys. I didn't record audio when I was filming because I was going out with some friends and I didn't have time. So I'm starting off with my No Pore Plum Primer. This is from Touch and Soul, and honestly, this is like my holy grail primer. I love it to death. It feels so nice on the skin, and it really does a good job of filling in my pores, and I just love it. It looks so good. It feels so good. It's a very silicone-based primer. The only thing with these is that you have to make sure that you really, really wash your face, and I also like to give my face a break when I'm not working or doing anything and I don't wear makeup. So I am looking down at my mirror, if you can't tell, which is why I'd let you know that if I wasn't looking at the camera. Because I don't have contacts in, so I can't see what I'm doing. So I have the Maybelline Superstay 24 Hour Foundation, and I have this in the shade 102. And this is what I'm going to be using on my face today. I'm also going to be using my Real Techniques metals, bold metals, whatever it is, that collection. And I really like this one because it's really, really soft, but it also covers a large surface area, so it takes less time for me to do my foundation because I have a very big round face. And please excuse the dirtiness of my sponge. I stained it with a foundation and with a cream blush that I have. This foundation looks very, 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 very pale on me on camera. But it actually is like one of the perfect shade for me. And I really, really like it. It has really good coverage. I like the look of it. It doesn't look too matte. It doesn't look too dry. But it still keeps my skin nice and matte. This is also one of the only foundations that I've found that doesn't break down on my skin after a while. I mean, I obviously have points like under my nose where I rub my nose a lot, and on like the sides of my nose that break down and wear off, but that's mostly because I rub my nose. Other than that, it stays on very well. It lasts for a long time, and it looks nice. So I just blend that, blend and 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 blend. And I take it all the way down my neck. And I keep blending and blending and blending and blending. And next, I'm going to be using the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. Mine in the shade C2. I talked about this in my last video, and this was my first time using it actually, so I wasn't sure how I was going to like it, but I ended up really, really enjoying it. It does remind me of the Tarte Shape Tape, but it almost looks a little bit glowier, not in the oily sense, but in like, it makes me look healthier. I feel like it's a little bit more hydrating, and I just really like the look of it, so I put it under my eyes, on my chin, on my cupid's bow, on the bridge of my nose, and a little bit on my forehead, just for highlighting. And then I blend it in with my Real Techniques sponge again. Sponge powder in the shade Translucent, and I get ready just to minimize creasing under my eyes. So I just tap some out underneath, and I use a brush to set my face, starting with my under eyes. Also, please ignore this hair that's sticking out in the middle of my forehead. It was driving me crazy through the whole filming, but I didn't have any bobby pins near me and I didn't feel like getting up. So after I'm done filling them in, I just like to brush them once more, focusing primarily towards the front, just to feather them out and blend it out a little bit more. Next, I'm gonna prime my eyes, and I use the Urban Decay Primer Potion to prime my eyes. I like this. It works. I don't know. Oh, that face was so horrible. So I just apply it to the top, and I blend it in with my fingers, but then I bring it down a little bit on the bottom sometimes, but I don't know if I did it here. But tonight I was in kind of a hurry to do my makeup, so it might not have been the most gentle episode. has 21 shades, and I really, 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 really liked it. So, to start out, I'm going to set my primer, and I'm using a Real Techniques Bold Metals brush, and this is the 200 brush. It's kind of a like round blender brush, and I really like it for just an overall wash of color. So to set my eyes, I used Weekender from the palette. And then as a transition color, I used Still Shot. And I worked that into my crease with a Morphe M433 brush. I also like to kind of drag all of my colors out and up a little bit, kind of creating a wing. Because I feel like it suits my eye shape, because I kind of feel like I have droopy eyes. So I like to try to bring them up when I can. And I'm just taking that color and working it into the crease, but also bringing it up a little bit more to act as a transition. Next, I'm going to be taking the color Baja with the same M433 brush, and I'm just going to work that into the crease. I like to use these warm orangey, reddish, pink tones because I think they really make my eyes pop. I have blue eyes, and colors like these are really good for making them pop and stand out because they are contrasting colors. I'm also working that color into my V and a little bit inwards into the inner part of my eye. Also, please don't mind the leftover mascara remnants that were on my eyelids. Sometimes I just don't remove my makeup well enough. We're all human, though. And then I like to connect it just a little bit under my eye, just to start bringing it down. Also listening to some music in the background. I always listen to upbeat music when I'm doing my makeup before going out, because it gets me pumped up. So now I'm just kind of putting it into the inner corner of my eye and connecting it in with the crease, and then deepening up the V, almost doing a halo eye, but I don't do a halo eye in the end. I just kind of liked having that on. 1.67, which is a flat brush, but it's rounded on the edge. And I like to use this to apply shimmer shades. Also, to make it a little bit more prominent, sprayed with my aloe vera spray. So I just put the pigment onto the brush and then I spray it. Zoom you in a little bit closer so you can see it. So basically, I apply it, kind of cutting the crease, but not really, because I didn't feel like applying any concealer to my eyelid. And I apply it to the first, I'd say 3/4 of my eye, just a little bit past my pupil. And then I kind of blend in the edges a little bit. So it was harder to blend. But it is what it is. But I did like the look of it in the end. It just took a little bit more work than usual. So I just added that to my outer corner. And a little bit through my crease, but I still wanted to keep the orange color there. Brush is really nice because it's a tapered blender. And it can really get into the crease very, very, very well. And it makes blending out the crease very easy. There was some fallout, as you can see. Underneath the wings of my eyes. But it was very easy to clean up with just a little bit of powder underneath my eyes. But that's nothing to complain about. Overall, I thought the palette was great. I need to play with it a little bit more. But I will say that I did actually do this look again, but I did it the right way. By putting on all the mattes and then putting on the shimmer, and it worked perfectly. So here, I've just taken my Beauty Blender, or my Real Techniques Sponge. by Benefit, and I use this to kind of contour my face, but not really contour. And I am using the Morphe M523 brush. Is really good for that because it's thick enough that it can make a line, but still thin enough that it's not like so outrageously thick. It's very good at hiding things. Now I'm going in with my Physicians Formula Butter Blush in the shade Vintage Rose. And I've been doing this new thing with my blush. I take this blush brush, it's the Real Techniques Bold Metals 300 brush. And I like to apply it to my nose and right under my eyes. And the tops of my cheeks, like my cheekbones. I don't know why, but I just really like the look of it. It makes me look sun-kissed, even though I don't go outside, like, ever. So it makes me look flushed. Next, I am curling my eyelashes, and as you can see in this video, I've curled my hair, but this hair stayed curled for this video's filming and editing, and that's it. So what I do with my eyelashes, because I do have long eyelashes, but they go straight down, is I heat up my eyelash curler with a lighter, and then I wait for it to get cool enough that I can use it on my eyelids, and I use that to curl my eyelashes. It works very well, and if I didn't do this, my eyelash would curl for a second, and as soon as I put mascara on, they would fall right back down. So I do that, and I kind of like push my eyelash curler into my eyes. So here I'm using the Lash Paradise by L'Oreal mascara, and then it's in the waterproof version. Like I said, my eyelashes do not stay curled, so I have to use waterproof mascara. Also, my bottom eyelashes are extremely long, and I like them to be long. And if I don't use waterproof mascara, they will transfer down to the bottom lash, to like under my eyes, and I look absolutely insane. my face. I feel like my favorite things to do is my eyebrows and my mascara. Those two things just are very therapeutic for me. I don't know why, but it's very relaxing to brush mascara goop through my eyebrows or my eyelashes. Sorry, I do not put regular mascara in my eyelashes. My eyebrows. Oh my gosh, I should stop talking right now. see what I'm doing, but I'm just applying mascara to my bottom lashes. I don't think you really, really need to see that.
Lately, I've been really enjoying glossy.
I'm still trying to get good at this ASMR thing, but thank you for watching. And if you like this,